again. I have a fun little project for you. First, I want to show you something I've been working on with my drawing class. I did this just for fun. Do you know who that is? Yeah, that's Waldo. Waldo likes to hide everywhere and it's fun to find him. Charlie and I love these books. So anyways, I thought I might teach you how to draw Waldo. So here we go. Again, sometimes it helps if you have something to look at. So I'm gonna look at this while I draw it. It may not be quite as good as this one, but it will give you the basic idea. Now, Waldo's head, I know I tell you to make an oval or an egg shape for a face, but look, his face, and he's kind of like a cartoon character, is kind of square. So I'm gonna start with a square. Then he has that small neck that I've been telling you about. He's looking kind of tilted to the side. And his shoulders are going down. Other arm going out. First, I'm just gonna do the, in drawing class, they always tell you to do the big shapes first. There's his waist. And then he's walking forward, so I'm gonna make it. And his other leg is behind. And shoes. On them. And that's hard to see. It might be a little hard to see. I'm going to trace it with my black marker. And that way you can follow along with me. So at the beginning, I'm just making sort of a square shape for the head. Little neck. Arm down. Body, his arm going this way, body, and he's walking forward. So we're gonna have one leg going forward this way, put a shoe on it, shoe has a little heel, the other arm behind, leg, behind. Okay, now, that's his basic body motion. Now let's put some details in. Okay. Armpit. His shirt. And his hand is going back like this. One, two, three. It doesn't mean he only has three fingers, but it means that's all we're seeing right now. This hand is going out here. We've got to finish the arm. And he has the thumb down. Just kind of like the other drawing where holding a bouquet of flowers. This time though, Waldo is holding a cane. So let's put the cane in between there. And it kind of goes as an angle. Like that. Okay, great. This is the pocket for his pants. He has a striped shirt. Stripes down the sleeves. And you can color those in. Again, I only have black, but if you know the Waldo books, his shirt is usually red and white with blue pants. Okay, now his face. Okay, ears. Like I've told you how to make ears, and he has glasses, like big circle, a little, that's called a bridge, another circle, glasses sit behind your ears, you have little eyes in there. And again, he's a cartoon character, so sometimes you don't make it exactly how you might make it, you know, with trying to draw a real life character. his character doesn't have eyebrows and eyelashes, things like that. Okay, got the face, and his smile is just going to be this shape. There, this is his chin. All right, now his hair. He has some on the sides, some boy hair. He's got some kind of coming out of his cap there into like triangle shapes. Then he's got a huge part that goes winging off. That's kind of fun. So you can make that shape zoom, like a wave. Again and again and again. Okay. And he's wearing a beanie kind of cap. With a little pom-pom on the top. It's sort of a round-shaped pom-pom. Okay, that's pretty good. Maybe not as good as my other drawing, but close. Now, I have an idea. Why don't you make a Waldo, color him in, then cut him out. You might want to make like a, cut him out not too close so that you don't snip off his hands or his feet or anything like that. Cut around, make yourself a nice little border to cut around. Then, hide it around the house. Put it near things like where there's lots of other patterns around, like, you know, maybe if you had a couch or something, hide it next to the couch if the couch has a print so it's hard to find him. And then have fun with either your brothers or sisters, mom or dad, asking them to find Waldo. Once they find him, then go put him somewhere else. You can make him this big, you can make him this big, or you can make him very big. The smaller you make him, the harder it is to find him, just like in those books. Okay, but that's kind of a quick version of how to make Where's Waldo. Have fun.